This is Rick with CyberMedics, and we're here today to talk about how to recover your Gmail account if, for whatever reason, you have lost access to your account through all of your devices. Maybe you jumped in the swimming pool with it, or your kids threw it in the swimming pool. Maybe Fido decided it was a chew toy and took it down the river. You were on a secret spy mission and your phone decided to self-destruct. You became frustrated at work and took it out in the parking lot and beat it to death with a hammer. Or your significant other got tired of you looking at your phone too long and decided to do a little barbecue trial and see how your phone would fare. For whatever reason, you don't have access to your account on any devices. We'll walk you through the account recovery and show you how to recover your Gmail account. So this assumes you are signed out of all of your devices. So log in and hopefully you know your password and email address. This also assumes that. Type in your email address, click next, type in your password, select next, and of course, it's going to be helpful right out of the gate. It wants to send you a verification code to a device that I don't have any longer. In fact, this happened to one of our subscribers, and they contacted us, reached out to us, and asked us if we could help them recover their account because it was linked to their YouTube channel. And that's what we like to do here at CyberMedics, is help people out with real problems. And if you have a similar problem and need some help, that's why we're here. So we reached out, this person reached out to us, and we walked them through on how to recover their account. So we'll go ahead and select verification code to the phone, and it wanted to send it to a phone that they no longer have access to. So we couldn't enter the code for that, so we select try another way. And it also knew there was an alternate device and wanted us to scan a QR code. That device was also not available. But if for some reason you had stayed logged into another device, you could go to this verify account location. But in this instance, we don't have access to any of the accounts. So now we'll go try another way. And it says more tips on recovering your account. So when we select that, we get into this account review information, and it says use your phone or security key, which we don't have. So scrolling down here, it's telling us that we can get a prompt to a phone, get a verification code by text, get a security code on our Android device, use a lock screen or fingerprint on an Android device. So none of this is going to help us, right? Because we don't have a device. So scroll down here. And under that, it says you can't use your phone. Yep, that's us. We cannot use our phone. So we select that. And it takes us to this page, how to recover your Google account or Gmail. So we didn't forget our password. We didn't forget the email address that we used to sign in. And down here, we did find something. It says, can't sign in for another reason. That's us. We can't sign in for another reason. So select that. It took us to this page. And one, two, three, four, five from the top is you are having trouble with second step verification. That is correct. That's us. We're having trouble with second step verification. So once we select that, it takes us to another page. And it says your phone is lost or you can't use it. That is us. Our phone is lost or we can't use it. All right. So we select that. And now you can see it's summarized our situation. You're having trouble with two-step verification. Your phone is lost and you can't use it. Correct. So we scroll down here. It says if you don't have a backup method, and that is the situation here. There's no, I can't emphasize enough, you should have had backup codes, you should have had a backup email address, but sometimes people just haven't set that up and it's not available, but highly encourage you to do that. Set up backup codes and a backup email address to your account. All right, so if you haven't already done this, follow the steps to recover your account. So we're going to do that. Click on that. And now this is the second attempt at account recovery. So we're going to enter the email address. Select next. And now it's giving us these squirrely text things that we have to fill out and read, which I always have to call my wife over to read these because it's just too hard for me to figure it out. But anyway, so next, now enter your password. Next. And it's again trying to send us back to one of our devices that we previously had signed into this account. So we're going to have to try another way. Select that because we cannot enter a code. And it's taking us back to another device that's been linked to the account. And that's not going to help us. So we have to try another way. Get a verification code sent to your phone, the phone that I do not have for the account. Okay, so we're going to try another way. Enter the last password that we had for the account. Next. And again, it's asking us to scan the QR code on a phone that is no longer linked to the account. So we're going to try another way. At this point, you might be thinking you're losing your mind, and you probably are. It's okay. Just hang in there. Now, so now it's going to go back to the Samsung account device that's linked to the phone. Of course, we don't have that, so we're going to select try another way. And it's going to tell me something that is not useful. I didn't provide enough information. Okay, yep, understand that. So we're going to try again. So we enter the email address, select next, and now it's coming back with the squirrely characters. Enter that, enter the last password. Just have to hang in here. It's gonna be okay. Next. Okay, don't have this iPhone, so try another way. And then the aha moment. And the aha moment was, when it said enter a phone number to get a text message, it's any registered phone. It's not one of the specific phones. So when it was coming up with this earlier in the demonstration and I was walking through the steps, I didn't realize that. So when I wound up entering my own cell phone number in here, then it texted me a code, even though that phone was not linked to the account. I entered that phone from my own phone number, selected next, and I was in their account. So, in summary, as you're walking through this process, now I think you will have to go through a lot of the steps that we went through here, and it may seem like you're kind of chasing your tail, but eventually you will get to this screen. And once you get to this screen with the phone that says enter a phone number, that's the point where you can enter the phone number and get the code so that you can get access back to your account. That concludes our video demonstration of how to recover your Gmail account if you've lost access to your devices. We showed you how to go through the account recovery and get your account back. I would be really interested in hearing feedback from people who have recovered their accounts. What were your experiences? What kind of hurdles did you run into? How did you overcome them? If you have any questions or comments, please post them below. Hope you will consider subscribing and have a great and wonderful automation day.